Listening Library presents Who Was David Bowie? By Margaret Gurevich. Read for you by Jake Wesley Rogers. Who was David Bowie? When audiences tuned in to their favorite British music show, Top of the Pops, on July 6, 1972, they didn't know what to expect from the singer they were about to see. Most had heard Space Oddity, his huge hit that had actually been broadcast in Britain during the US Apollo 11 moon landing 3 years before. Some viewers had also bought his two most recent albums, Hunky Dory and The Rise and Fall of Ziggy Stardust and the Spiders from Mars. However, many people had never seen David Bowie perform live. They didn't even know what he looked like. Then David stepped up to the mic. His hair was bright red, and he wore a rainbow-colored shiny jumpsuit and red boots. He also wore makeup. The audience wasn't sure what to think, but he certainly had their attention. He grabbed the mic to sing Starman, a song from the Ziggy album. As he sang, he put his arm around his guitarist, Mick Ronson. Some people were uncomfortable. They weren't used to seeing men wearing makeup on television. They also didn't like that David was hugging another man. But he didn't care what they thought. He was only being himself. He pointed at the television audience as he sang. Viewers felt like he was talking to them and just maybe giving them permission to be themselves too. It really felt as if he were speaking personally to everyone who was watching. That night, the man in the blue eyeshadow and sparkly clothes dressed as Ziggy, a character from his most recent album, strummed his blue guitar and showed Britain who he was. It had taken him 9 years to become this successful. It was finally happening, and on his own terms. Chapter 1. Absolute Beginners. David Robert Jones was born in Brixton in South London, England, on January 8, 1947. He had two older siblings, a half-sister, Annette, and a half-brother, Terry. His parents were Haywood Stenton Jones, called John, and Margaret Mary Burns, known as Peggy. John worked for a children's charity called Barnardo's, and Peggy worked as a waitress. When David was six, he and his parents moved to the Bromley neighborhood of London. Shortly after, Annette moved away, and Terry joined the Air Force. At that time, parts of England were still recovering from World War II. Rubble littered the streets, and David and his friends sometimes played in old bomb shelters. David's childhood was a happy one. His parents always encouraged music. Peggy spoke about David's grandfather, who played wind instruments. His father bought a record player, something few families could afford. In elementary school, David participated in art and music classes and sang in the choir. He also loved all things American, even baseball and American football, which were both unpopular in England. His favorite music was American, too. He and his cousin Christina often danced to records by Elvis Presley, a famous American singer. Rock and roll. Rock and roll became widely popular in the United States in the mid-1950s. With its roots in country music and rhythm and blues, it included musical instruments such as electric guitars, drums, electric bass, piano, saxophones, and trumpets. Elvis Aaron Presley, 1935 to 1977, was an American singer, musician, and actor who is called the King of Rock and Roll. During one television appearance, he was only shown from the waist up because some people found his dancing inappropriate. Elvis recorded dozens of albums and hit songs, including Heartbreak Hotel and Jailhouse Rock. He further popularized music that originated in black communities and made rock and roll famous throughout the world. Around this time, David's mother took him to see the American rock and roll artist Little Richard perform in a movie. That show sparked his interest in the saxophone. Shortly after, he begged his father to loan him money for the instrument. He worked part-time jobs to earn the rest. That Christmas, David finally received his saxophone. It was white with gold keys. When David was 11, Terry returned. He introduced David to jazz, a popular American music known for its improvised sound. When musicians improvise, they make up notes as they play, rather than playing something they've already memorized. That year, David graduated from elementary school. For his secondary school, he chose Bromley Technical High School because of its music and art classes. He and his friends played their guitars at lunch and performed in an end-of-the-year school concert. When he was 16, David saw his first live music performance. It was Little Richard. He loved how Little Richard jumped on stage and stood on his white grand piano. At one point, he clutched his heart and fell to the floor. David thought Little Richard was dying. Suddenly, the performer raised his head and shouted, "A wop bop a loo bop a lop bam boom!" The audience cheered. David never forgot that exciting performance. In addition to the saxophone, David also learned to play the ukulele and piano. He and his friends sometimes made their own instruments and formed a band called the Conrads. One day, David and another band member, George Underwood, got into a fight. George punched David right in the eye. After 4 months in the hospital and many surgeries, his left pupil looked much larger than his right. His eyes looked like they were two different colors. George felt awful, but David forgave him. His unique eyes became his favorite feature. In 1963, all 16-year-old David wanted to do was sing and play instruments. He imagined himself wowing audiences just like Little Richard. That year, David graduated high school and began working in an advertising company. But the work, cutting and pasting designs on paper, was boring to him. He looked forward to evenings when he could play with the Conrads. Unfortunately, the late nights tired him out the next morning. David realized he couldn't be a rock star and work in an office too. He quit the agency and formed a new band called Davy Jones and the King Bees. David was the saxophone player and lead singer. He dreamed of making it big. His father also had huge hopes for him. He helped David write a letter asking companies to manage the King Bees. One of his letters compared the King Bees to the Beatles, the most popular rock group in the world at that time. David's confidence worked. Leslie Kahn, a talent scout, asked the King Bees to audition. Unfortunately, the band played so badly he stopped them mid-set. David was so upset he cried. But even if he didn't know what it was, Leslie saw something in the King Bees and decided to manage them anyway. In 1964, the King Bees put out a single called Liza Jane. It flopped, and David searched for a new band again. He joined the Mannish Boys in 1965. At the time, the mod look was in style. Mods dressed in three-piece suits, ties, and fancy shoes. David decided this should be the image of a lead singer. But he needed more than style to get noticed. Leslie knew good stories got attention and helped David create his own. He appeared on television and talked about how people made fun of his long hair. It wasn't true, but it got the Mannish Boys extra publicity. Unfortunately, it wasn't enough to make them successful, and David once again searched for a new band. He found a group called the Lower Third and a manager named Ken Pitt. Since there already was a well-known singer named Davy Jones, in a band called the Monkees, Ken asked David to change his last name, but only for his career. His real name remained David Jones. He picked the name Bowie after Jim Bowie, an American pioneer. He thought the name made him sound tough. Jim Bowie even had a knife named after him. David called it the ultimate American knife. With a new name and mod style, David hoped his career would reach new heights too. Chapter 2. Who Can I Be Now? David was 20 years old and things were looking up. In 1967, Derham Records, a new music company, gave him a solo recording contract. This meant they only wanted David.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.